Hello everybody and welcome back to Southwest Norway. As you can see, we've got a New Holland T5 here. This is a T5115 or the 115, not too sure. This is a new tractor to our yard. We're going to add it to the yard of tractors. We have actually just got rid of the Deutzfahr because a lot of people were requesting me to get rid of it because it's an overused tractor, although it isn't a bad tractor. So I have replaced it with the New Holland T5. I know that I do get a lot of requests to use more Case IH, so I will do in the future on a different map, but for this map, I think we'll probably stick with what we've got now because there isn't too much longer left on the series. Also on the back, we've got the class liner because this is going to have to be used today. This is the 2700. Yes, that thing anyway. We need this bigger one because I need to row up many of the swaths together. I just worry that the smaller one won't be big enough, it won't be wide enough to do a decent job. So we've had to go and rent this one for a day. But yes, the tractor is bought. That is our tractor. We have paid for it outright. So yeah, that's all good. This tractor also does have the suspension. I think it's a seat suspension actually, because we are moving independently from the cab. But yes, this is from the New Holland pack. A very good pack it is too. So yes, the field number 4 is the field we're going to start off with, but we're not going to go with the tractor straight away because we haven't finished the harvest. I almost have been doing it off screen because we've been doing quite a lot of it recently. So we'll just put this at the side. We are pretty much there though, so if you don't want to watch harvesting, then just skip forward a few minutes. So yes, let's just go over here. I've already sold a trailer load from here. We've had £15,000 worth out of this. Super loud. Yes, it was on a worker for some of the time. Put the auger in. And we'll just get it completed. But yeah, I'm sure you can see that we do need to rake it before we bale it because it's really messy. Most of the time it's me that's making it messy rather than anything else. Like doing stuff like that, it's quite a messy thing to do. But yes, we've just got this triangle to clear up. And yeah, this is terrible. This is the worker. Thank you, worker, for making such a mess. You're as bad as me. But yeah, only a couple of minutes left to do with this. Surprisingly, we're almost full once again. I've unloaded this about 7 times already just from this field. The yield is too good. It's not every day you get someone complaining that the yield is too good. Yeah, I almost sideswiped the trailer. Always get the triangle at the end. Maybe it's just me, but I always get a triangle at the end of the harvest. Only with the obscure shapes though. If it's a square field, I never get a triangle. Unless I'm drunk or something, but that's very rare. In fact, that is never. Never. Never at all. Right, let's unload. And I think we'll just tip it in the yard for now because, yeah, we don't want to be doing too much driving. Got to crack on with the rowing up, and next week we'll be doing the baling, hopefully with the Class Rollant baler. That is a round baler, I believe. But yes, I just think it's going to fit in very well. In fact, the class equipment I seem to be going for quite a bit recently. I've got the class liner here. In fact, yeah, the combine, we can actually just drive straight in down here into the yard. That is easy. Very easy. We'll have to go and fetch the trailer later on. There we go. And yes, the Vultra Valmet tractor. It's just going to take us over to the tipping point. We can shut the door if it'll work. Oh, there we go. think it's a pit because there's a silo, and we filled up from the silo's auger. That tractor is definitely moving. It is moving on its own. I never parked it like that. It's kind of blocking the way. It is blocking the way. Well, we'll get that tipped into storage anyway. And for now, we'll just put it over here. I say I'm going to tidy up, and then I'm still going to dump stuff. But we do need to continue very quickly with this lining, because we've got two fields to do. Field number four being quite big and very messy, so it's going to take a bit of work. But we do need to get it all done today, because it needs to be ready for the next episode. And this tractor is a lot quieter than the other two machines. Right, I think we'll go clockwise around the field. I really hope. Actually, is this thing the same size? Is it the same size? I think it is, actually. I didn't really need to get this, but I suppose we could sell the other one. This is only rented anyway, and it costs us about £800 or something to rent for a day. Yeah, that is not good. It does actually, it can pull them both in, but you've got to be very good. You've got to be a very good driver, which usually I'm not. But actually, no, it is still tidying things up quite well. It's not the ideal situation, but it's still much better than it was. Like on the corner here. Really messy. But that joins the two together. Yeah, that is working. So this should make baling a lot easier. I like that the mirrors are perfectly aligned, so you can see it in the mirror. And yeah, T5 tractor, not a bad tractor actually. Obviously it's between the T4 and the T6. The T4, in my opinion, for most of the jobs we do, is too small. In real life, obviously it's going to be a very handy tractor. The T6 for some stuff we do is too big. So yes, the T5 is a very good all-round tractor, especially for this farm, because we don't really want massive equipment. T5 is perfect. Perfect for our New Holland needs. Don't know if I said before, but yeah, a few years ago now, I went to the Basildon New Holland plant where they manufacture these tractors. Very interesting place. It's nice to see them being assembled right in front of your eyes on the production line. It really does make you appreciate the amount of work that is actually put into building these things, and the dedicated workers there, because everyone's got their own assigned job and they stick with that job, and they've got to keep doing that same thing. So if their job is, for example, I don't know, just putting the wheels on, they'll be putting the wheels on, and I think that is pretty much all they do. I suppose doing it that way though, it means that each person is going to be so good at what they do that everything will be done properly. But yeah, that was a good day, that. What this is doing is making the swath a lot narrower. I've always thought that combine swath is quite wide, and people have said this to me a few episodes ago about the benefits and the disadvantages of having a wider swath. I think it might be just a tiny bit too wide, because when you are baling, it does make it quite tricky. Obviously it's not too bad, but yeah, the swath, the width of the swath which is produced with the rake is ideal really. But yeah, this is the worst bit, the middle, because you really are just cutting a tiny bit at a time, and you make such a mess doing it. Well, I do anyway. Actually, I've still missed bits. Useless, absolutely useless. These people, some people with OCD who watch my videos, and I know it does annoy you, I apologise. yes, probably best just not to pay attention to the leftover straw which is on the ground. I am the same with grass, I know. Just imagine that I didn't miss it, and then I go and drive over what I've done. not good. But this is Farming Simulator. It doesn't matter too much. Realism is key, but realism doesn't need to be obsessed over. I think that is this field almost done. It actually hasn't taken very long at all. I thought it would take a while, but clearly even this smaller rake is very fast. When I was deciding which T5 to go for, this is actually the biggest T5 you can get in the mod pack. I didn't really know which one to get, which horsepower, because I can't imagine this rake's going to require too much horsepower. In fact, it recommends 50. I don't know if that's right or not, but yeah, clearly 50 is okay. This is 115, this tractor. But I didn't really know which horsepower to go for. But yes, if we do need to do anything which requires high horsepower, for example the baling, then this tractor can be quite good for it. In fact, yeah, this tractor probably is perfect for a Rollant baler. I don't know. We'll have to give it a go. I know that the 3080 Massey Ferguson will definitely power it, so if the worst comes to the worst, we can just stick that on it and that will sort the issue. Now, this field isn't too bad. It's not horrendous, but it probably could do with being sorted out a little bit. With regards to Farm Expert 2017, at the time of recording this video, I have produced the first look video, but I haven't released it yet, so I don't know what response it got. But I personally do like the game. I think it's good. It's obviously you obviously can't say it's amazing yet because it's still work in progress. The version I've got is the pre-release version. But there is definitely a lot of aspects about that game which are very, very good. For example, the 3D ploughing furrows, and also the weather, dynamic weather is good. And there was another big thing which I did think of. Oh yes, it was basically the amount of stuff you can do, like stuff like strawberries you can do. What you can do in the greenhouses is actually way more advanced than Farming Simulator. So yes, there are a lot of really good things about that game, but without doing a proper let's play, which I'm hoping to do, yes, it's going to be quite hard to actually rate it. I don't know the actual rating for it yet because I can't do that without playing the released version, because you don't know what glitches it's going to have, or it might not have any at all, hopefully. So yeah, please do let me know down in this video as well. I probably know by now at the time of watching this because it's been released, but yeah, give me your thoughts about that video. I'd love to know, and the game more importantly, but yeah, the video as well. Do you like the way I do the gameplay? Would you like to see a let's play of that? Or, I don't know, do you want to just stick with Farming Simulator? I try and do other games as well, so I do a lot of Farming Simulator, but I do like to do other games. At the moment, it's trying to, you know, squeeze those videos into the upload time because I'm having so much issues with these uploads. But next week, the internet will be sorted, hopefully. I should have fast internet from next week onwards, and I should be getting many, many more videos out to you. Maybe not straight away, because I'll still be I have a backlog of videos. So for example, this video today, although it's been released on Sunday, I think it's Sunday, it was recorded, what day is it today? I don't know. I don't know what day it is. It's Wednesday, I think. Yeah, recording this on the Wednesday for release on the Sunday. I have to do this because you never know, I could be ill or whatever. I could come down with this awful streaming cold and I won't be able to do videos. Actually, I do still do videos when I have a cold. It doesn't sound very good, and thankfully it doesn't happen very often, but I do. Last year I had this awful sore throat and cold and I could barely talk, but I didn't miss a day. The dedication is there. I can't bear to miss a day of releasing a video, because it's basically turned from something in which I used to just, oh, let's just make a video for fun, to something which I now, it's part of my daily routine. If I didn't do a video, it would feel wrong. I wouldn't be able to relax. I can't relax until I've done the video of the day, which sounds very sad, in a way. But no, I do have to do my daily video. It is part of it. It's like breakfast. You can't go the day without eating breakfast. You have to eat your breakfast. You do. I have to do my video. Okay, I better shut up now because I'm sounding really sad here. But yeah, that is how I work. I do have to do a video a day. I think if I was too ill, I probably wouldn't do a video, but hopefully the backlog of videos would continue to release day after day until I'm better, and it would be seamless. You wouldn't even know I was ill. That's the plan anyway. But there are other things as well, not necessarily if I'm ill. Maybe if I go on holiday or something, then I can still release the videos and it would be seamless. Alright, there we go. We're done. Let's just drive out of here. I don't think that was a designated entrance, but we've gone through it anyway. If it's not a hedge, I reckon you can go through it. Or a fence, or a wall. So we do need to go and get the header trailer back. Obviously it has been dumped over there, behind us, way away. I think it's rolled away as well. I think we'll probably get it with a different tractor. Where can this go? In there. Yeah, that's kind of foolish. I didn't realise... Actually, it's not going to fit. I didn't realise this would be the same machine. It is actually the same one, just a reskin of... I think it's a coon we already have. That isn't going to fit in there. We'll put it over here instead. I'm very bad at sorting out machinery. I do dump stuff around, which is not good. But we do need to go out and get the header trailer. As long as stuff isn't in the fields, then it's okay, in my opinion. As long as it's in the yard, I don't really mind, but other people do. Yes, it's the same as that. The Coon GA8521. It's just a reskin. I tend to turn the gearbox off on this because I prefer just to have it in automatic. Probably a bad thing, actually. It probably is good in manual, but I've never really used it. So these two fields are now ready to bale. That'll be next week's job. And I'm trying to decide whether or not we should use an auto stacker or if we do it manually to move the bales. I think I might use an auto stacker because you know what my stacking is like. It's not good at all. It really isn't. It's not worth watching. But I'm really looking forward to seeing what the physics of the bales are going to be like in Farming Simulator 17, because every single one gets better. So 13 was worse than 15, and well, the less said about 09, the better, I think. But yes, it definitely does improve with every version which is released. Yes, 09 was diabolical, but that was the first time that bale handling was put into the game, so fair enough. You've got to start somewhere. It is now possible, actually, for skilled operators in Farming Simulator to stack bales very well without the need of any auto-stacking mods at all. Me not being one of those people, obviously, but I know it is possible. And if you can do that, it means that the bale handling physics must be pretty good. Otherwise, it wouldn't be possible. Right, we'll put this here. Nice open area to put the header onto the trailer. I think that's, it must be a dryer or something. It's very noisy. Very noisy. So is this. So we'll just put this header onto the trailer, and I think that'll be it for this week, because yeah, without getting the new baler, which I haven't downloaded yet, I'm not really going to be able to do too much. Oh yeah, we've adjusted the header with the mod. This does need to be rectified. We need to put the cutter up by pressing left shift and N. No, that puts it down. We need to put it up by pressing left shift and N, like I said. There we go. Hopefully that's high enough. Yes, I'm not really concentrating today. It's one of those days. Is that going to go on? Okay, it's actually nowhere near. There we go. I had it in the down position, you absolute fool. There we go. Perfect. So we'll just put this over here, out of the way. We'll lock the header onto the trailer, and that'll be everything done. So, yeah. Actually, is it on enough? That'll be the next thing. No, it isn't. Actually, does it... Oh, this one might not lock on. Not too sure. Thought it did do, but possibly not. But it doesn't matter. It is on the trailer at least. So that is it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. And like I say, next week we'll be doing the baling with the Class Roland Baler. So until then, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.